Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So it's been a while since I've done a sit down. Well, no, that's a lie. I did a sit down video last week because I went through my review of the Loewe puzzle bag. Anyway, for those who are new, my name is Meg. For those who have been here before, welcome back. Very raw looking today. I don't have any foundation or anything on my face with exception of SPF. And eye makeup is very minimal, just mascara and eyeliner and a few eyebrows. And I drew in my eyebrows, that's what I meant. Anyway, what are we going to talk about today? So I thought I'd sit down and show you some of the things that I bought recently. Now these are Christmas gifts from husband or from myself. So I think I'll start off with the simplest one, which is a pack of candles from Bath & Body Works. It's been ages since I've seen a haul that involved Bath & Body Works from YouTubers, because now they're hauling all this expensive stuff. So anyway, Bath & Body Works here in Sydney has a 3-for-2 sale. So you buy three candles, or three items. It's not even just limited to the candles. Three items in the store, and you'll pay for only two. The cheapest one is free. And I'm just removing the tissue paper so I can show you which ones they are. So the first one that I chose is called Lavender Vanilla. And as the name suggests, the notes are lavender and vanilla. Made with essential oils, white barn scented candle. What does it say here? Yeah, well basically yeah, it's lavender and vanilla essential oils. And this is a single wick candle. These things are freaking expensive. Like, I paid $64 for three. And that's already 3-for-2. That means that it's $32 for each one. The next one is more of a Christmassy one. It's Hot Cocoa and Cream scented candle. Again, a single wick. Because by the way, the 3-week candles are $50 each. And I just couldn't get myself to pay that. Anyway, so that's cocoa and cream. And it does smell like hot cocoa, and I'm so excited to burn this. That's like, it's almost literally burning your money. Anyway, the last one is Marshmallow Fireside, which is a classic. It's like, I see this every Christmas season. What are the notes on this one? It doesn't really say. It says it just burns approximately 25 to 45 hours. I don't know why. Oh, I guess I know why. Charcoal colored because fireside. But anyways, those are the three items. And now I'm going to show you a bag that I purchased from Coach. It is the Madison, it's the larger one because I know they also have a mini Madison. And then during the unboxing, I will be talking to you about the bag, whether it's staying or whether it's not. And then when I come back, I'll then tell you whether I kept it or not. Hey guys, welcome to an unplanned unboxing. I wasn't planning on buying this Coach bag, but I saw it a couple of days ago in the store. I was actually eyeing something else. And if you follow me on Instagram, you would know what that is. But when I saw this, I was like, wow, that's pretty. And it was on sale. So I wanted to get it, but I was also thinking I've got too many bags. So said no Luxe bag addicts ever, but yeah, that was my thinking. Like I was like, I already have too many bags, so maybe I don't need this. Well, I don't really need it. I just wanted to buy it. Anyway, the reason why my face is not on screen today is because I've just come back from shopping. I'm all sweaty and unkempt, and I just can't face the camera, but I also can't be bothered to put on any makeup. So we're gonna do this unboxing without me on the screen. I had asked them to wrap it up for me because I thought that they were going to wrap it up with the usual sort of copper colored ribbon that they would use for gift wrapping. And right now I'm seeing that the box is nicked. And I'm a little bit scared because when I saw this, I asked the sales associate if they still had one in stock, a new one that hasn't been touched by anyone else, because the one on display had scratches on it and it's refined calf skin or calf leather, so it easily scratches. And she said yes, but then I never got to inspect which one she's put in the box. So I'm a little bit scared that maybe this isn't, maybe she gave me the display one. I don't know. Anyway, that's what the box looks like. She's put on like a sticker on either side, like so. And that's me ruining that. Yeah. So that's the box top there. This is the bag. She didn't even like properly stick that on. I don't know why. It's got the Coach tissue paper. It's got that horse and carriage print on it. You probably wouldn't be able to tell from the lighting, but I'm just gonna do a reveal. She's put it in the dust bag. There we go. So you can tell that this is not a Coach factory outlet item because it came in the dust bag. Normally, at least here in Australia, if you buy from the factory outlet, you don't get a dust bag. But here we go. Here's the reveal. Oh, this might be the new one because everything's still all packed up. Are you ready? Are you ready for this? I don't have anything this color. I love the look of it. I was a little bit hesitant, but here we go. Enough with the suspense. Look. Look at how beautiful that ombre effect is on that smooth, refined leather. But I can also tell that there are scratches on it. Oh God, I think I'm returning this. Yep. There's scratches on it. There. Some at the bottom. She's got that hang tag there. Now the thing is, and I know they're telling the truth about this because I went to three different Coach stores here, and one didn't have any. The other one said that they would check the other store because they only had the one item in display. And then the other one said that they had one in stock, and that's the one that I got. But I don't know if you can see that, but I can see a scratch there, a scratch there. Oh, how disappointing. A scratch there. There we go. So, yeah. I mean, I understand that this kind of leather really is prone to scratching, but yeah, I don't want to get a new bag that's already scratched up. I really like the black hardware on it. And I'm just going to put a picture in for you to be able to see what the chain looks like, because this comes in the black chain with interwoven leather. Like pretty much like how Chanel does their classic flaps. And that's what really attracted me to it as well. But I don't want to do anything more with it because I don't want to add to any of the scratches, and I want to keep it the way it is because I'm returning it, and I don't want them to say, well, I did the scratching, because I didn't. Okay. I mean, just look at her. That ombre effect is just so pretty. And again, I don't have anything that is this color, but I paid $495 for this. It was originally, what was it? $725. And I was gonna wait until Boxing Day because I know that with Boxing Day, they usually have another set of percentages off the sale price. But because there was only this, there's only three left, two of them were display ones. So, yeah, really bummed by that. Should I keep it? I mean, can you see it? Can you even see it? You probably can't see it. But it's right there. Right there. On the side. Yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna return this. This was actually an impulse buy anyway. I probably really should have thought about it. I had a feeling that this was gonna happen because she never showed me what the bag was, or the one that was new. So, yeah, it's got. But while we're here, it's got a back. There's. You can probably see from there. There's scratches on the back as well. So there's a big back pocket. It's got a turn lock. That's their hang tag there. It's got a zipped compartment or a zipped pocket at the back, which also is a slip pocket. And then this flap here opens up to another pocket, another compartment, and then a slip pocket in the front. This is probably how I would have wanted the Chanel classic flap to be designed. So it is double flap, but it's not cumbersome to get into. But yeah, I'm gonna have to really think about this. But every time I turn on the light, I can see the scratches, and it's irking me. And I can tell that in time there would just be more scratches. Yeah, so there she is. My unboxing for you guys, and I'm gonna rebox it. Because I'm returning this. I don't want a bag that's already been scratched up before I can even use it. And for $500, yeah, I think that's a bit high for something like this. Okay, probably gonna go tomorrow to return it. I don't want to keep looking at it because I feel like I'm going to fall in love and I'm not going to want to return it. So, yeah. Yep. It's a little bit disappointing. Yeah, I didn't keep it. I returned it within the same hour after unboxing it because I didn't want to wait until a few days later when they would be able to say, oh, maybe you scratch it with your own fingers, because I obviously didn't. Anyways, the next item is going to involve a little bit of a time lapse because it is a huge item. This is a gift from the husband. And yeah. As you can probably tell, I'm not somebody who waits for Christmas to open her presents. I've long accepted that I am not somebody who has that kind of patience, but also I want to be able to use this to go to work before we actually go into the Christmas break. Our office shuts down from December 23 to January 12th. So yeah, I wanted to make sure that I would have some use of this because when we come back the following year, we're going to be moving to an office here in the city, so I would just be walking. Anyways, here we go. right. So yes, the husband did buy me a Segway 9-bot Max G30. Well, actually, I bought it myself. He just transferred the money to me. I was actually looking at the Segway 9-bot F40, which is a newer release. But this Max G30 actually has a longer range of up to 65 kilometers. Also has better battery life. And it's just a bit more sturdy. It is almost $200 more than the F40, but the husband said, look, get the best kind, get the top of the line, because you don't want to be buying something now and then upgrading to something else later, which is a lesson he learned when he bought his bike. He bought a bike which isn't cheap either, but then ended up buying a $6,000 bike, which is a much more professional one now that he's realized he loves cycling. So anyways, I digress. Those are the things that are meant to be my Christmas gifts to myself and from the husband. There is one item that I am eyeing. I've been thinking about this since it first came out a couple of years ago, and it's released a second generation. I'm thinking it'll release a third generation pretty soon. Might wait for the third generation, might buy the second generation now, I don't know. But I've been eyeing it, and it has to do with vlogging, right? So I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comment section down below if you have any questions, comments, if you want me to review any of these items. Well, actually, there's only one that's probably worth reviewing. Anyway, sorry for rambling on and on, but yeah. If I don't see you, well, I'll still see a couple of videos later, but happy holidays to you guys. If you're not celebrating Christmas, if you're celebrating Hanukkah, if you're celebrating any other kind of holidays this coming holiday season, then I hope you enjoy it with you and your family.